Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy and blessings be with you all. Welcome back everyone to our Ramadan special on the 10 Qur'anic principles of an ideal community. The 8th Qur'anic principle of an ideal community is equity for all. Allah commands us in the Qur'an, O you who have faith, stand firm in equity, qist, as witnesses for Allah, even if it were against yourselves, or your parents, or your relatives. Whether rich or poor, Allah is more worthy of both. Follow not your desires, so that you may be just. Many societies in our current world value the principle of equality. However, beyond just equality, Islam values the principle of equity. The Quran uses the term qist for equity. However, qist can also be translated as just or fair distribution. In this case, equity is both tied to justice and fairness as a necessary prerequisite. Without equity, there can be no justice. Equality discerns everyone as equal despite core differences of privilege and ability. Equity, on the other hand, realizes that every individual is different, whether in circumstances, physiology, ability, privilege, and so on. But regardless of these differences, we are to strive for fair distributions of justice to ensure equity for all. More importantly, while equity discerns practical differences between individuals, it still promotes a standard of equality before Allah. For example, while the poor and rich are equal in the eyes of God, they are not equal in their practical circumstances. As a result, the poor are entitled to a portion of the wealth that we accumulate over a year. Because while it remains in our possession, we are not entitled to it. Rather, it is the poor who have a right over this money. Thus, zakat strives for equity. However, if the poor and rich were treated as equals, then they would both be entitled to zakat, which would be unjust and unfair to the poor. We are also commanded in Islam to provide equity beyond ethnicity, race, gender, or status. One prime example is that of Bilal radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him. He was a black slave who accepted Islam, and because of which was persecuted and tortured daily by his masters. Yet Bilal would continue to proclaim, Ahad, the one true God. Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, eventually went on to purchase his freedom so that he would be a free man and practice his faith. As the first African American to embrace Islam, Bilal was given great honor. For instance, the conquest of Mecca in the 8th Hijri calendar, the city surrendered and all the nobles from the Muslims and non-Muslims stood in the courtyard. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, asked Bilal to climb the roof of the Holy Kaaba and recite the call to prayer from the top of it. This was the first adhan ever given in Mecca. The Quraysh could never have imagined that a black man would be given preference over them. This was due to Bilal's devotion to Islam and his piety that he rose to such heights of spiritual attainment and the equity in Islam to allow for such opportunities. Equity contains many other components such as giving charity, giving truthful testimony, even if it hurts you but is for the sake of truth. Not rewarding others by playing favorites, rewarding others based on their merits even if you do not personally like them, and being fair for the sake of upholding the truth. As we embark on this journey of creating a more ideal community, let us remind ourselves to be fair and honest in our dealings with others, and not play into the hands of nepotism and favoritism, so that we may ensure equity.
Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more episodes. Donate generously to Majlis al-Shura, Islamic Leadership Council of New York, in this blessed month of Ramadan and maximize your reward. Your contributions will help us work together to build a more ideal community.